Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar.
والسلام على رسول الله الرحمة المهداة والنعمة المستاء والعلاه وأعوذ بالله من شرور الأنفس ومن سيئات الأعمال من يهدي الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا We are in the في الدرجة الرابعة he was talking about Imam al-Ghazali rahmullah in the four categories of the money come from people of authority. He said some of it mixed with halal, some of it mixed with haram. He said but some of them it mixed with, is more halal than in haram at that time. It is okay for a person to be paid or get that from that money because the majority of his is halal. But Imam al-Ghazali said أن أموال الصلاتين في عصرنا حرام كلها أو أكثرها. He said the money of salatin at his time almost is all of his haram or most of his haram. He says because that even the jizya, which is the tax money people of other faith pay, he says people becoming committed injustice toward people of the people of the book. أنواع الظلم لا يحل أخذها به فإنهم يجاوزون حدود الشرع. They close they cross all the boundaries and they don't follow Sharia of collecting this kind of money. And therefore he says and some of the money that they have collected through rashwa وصنوف الظلم that the bribery and all kind of the form of injustice. He says also people at the at his time قال وأن الظلم في هذا العصر لأقرب عهد لقرب عهد بزمان الخلفاء الراشدين كانوا مستشعرين من ظلمهم ومتشوفين لاستعمالة القلوب الصحابة والتابعين وحريصين على قبولهم وعطاياهم وجوائزهم. He said that even if people who committed injustice, those who are the first century, they wanted to get the Sahaba and the companions and the Tabi'in closer to them by giving them something without them asking, the companions asking for the money. But he says, what is prohibited is to humiliate yourself before somebody in authority and to show them love and so forth, although they you know that they committed injustice, so you can get dunya from their hand. Isn't that what's happening now? A person, you know a person committing injustice, want money from them, that he or she, they will do everything to get that money by approving even the injustice. And he said that's not, no one with aqil, of rational, would think this is halal. Another الثاني في هذا الباب في قدر المأخوذ وصفة الآخذ. He said now how much a person can take and who the person is eligible to be paid. He said no government should pay people for political favor. You have to pay a person because he deserves to be paid. I have X or Y as my friends, I will need their political support. I take from the public money and pay them money. That's not acceptable. لأخذ الولاء. Because you're taking the money of the that collected from taxes and others to do that. And then he said, people look at as how he thinking, rahimahullah. He said also that the government can hire people to do a job that no one will be able to do except the people they've been hired for. Teachers, doctors, army. Those people can be paid, you know, from the public money. Although they have a share in paying, contributing to the public money, but they can be hired to do so. And also, he said, also scholars, Maslahat al-Abdani and Maslahat al-Adiyan, for protection of deen and protecting of badan, or human life, like doctors or scholars. And he said that people can be rewarded on their effort more than the others. What Imam al-Ghazali is saying here? Listen to this carefully. There's a public money, and you pay a specialist doctor more than the residency doctor. And you pay somebody have written more books than lesser person have done less than that. You pay a person work longer than the person work less. What he's saying, this long time ago, what did he say? What idea he said should not be in government dealing?
Communism.
Well, he said every person would be paid the same. No. You pay people based on their effort. He said nothing wrong with that. A person have done more effort deserve to be paid more. You don't create laziness. Okay? You reward people who done more. But he says that this is, in general, is what permissible and acceptable. But he says there's something that we need to think about, which is how we deal with Salatin al-Dhalama, dictators, oppressors, how we deal with them. أحدهما أن السلطان ظالم عليه أن يكف عن ولايته. Maybe that sultan should not become in charge. وهو إما معزول أو واجب العزل. فكيف يجوز أن يؤخذ من يده وهو على التحقيق ليس بسلطان. A person who is an oppressor, a dictator, is a person who is not right to be a sultan. He said he shouldn't. People should not support that person. Like we're saying, don't take money from them, because by that we get support, because he was not become in charge in the right way. والثاني أنه ليس يعم بماله جميع المستحقين فكيف يجوز لأحد أن يأخذه فيجوز لهم الأخذ بقدر حصصه أم لا يجوز أصلا أم يجوز أن يأخذ كل واحد ما أعطى. He said the second question is that this person who is want to keep his power, he used the public money for inner circle. How can a person accept that money when he knows he will not give it to other people, only for him or his close friends? A person should not accept that. But he says, what if that person who as a dictator, like you know some dictators, Muslim dictators have built different masajid, you know this. In Latin America, you see their pictures still now, they passed away a long time ago, they have their pictures. They build masajid even in some of the suburbs of America. Would you accept the money from them? Yeah, you know what he said, Imam al-Ghazali? He says, if we took, you take the money, it's better for them than using the money in the wrong place. That he said. But if they use the money to build those places, masajid and so on, to justify the injustice, then people should not accept it. You know what I mean? A person would take people's life and then build a mosque to for PR. He said that should not be accepted because you're helping them to do so. Right? Now,
but it's not their money. When I have a question. When these presidents or kings and even current And they build all these hospitals or these mosques. Does it count as a sadaqa jariyah for them?
No.
It's not their money.
No, it's not their money. Now, al-Bab al-Sadis, he's talking about something very interesting. Imam al-Ghazali, rahimahullah, يقول فيما يحل من مخالفة السلطين الظلمة وما يحرم. What is permissible for a person to engage with salatin, which is the people in power, authority, who are unjust. وما يحرم. What is permissible, what's not permissible. وحكم غشيان مجالسهم. And how, what is permissible, what is the ruling of visiting them in their policies or their place of والدخول عليهم والإكرام لهم, and a person to honor them. قال الحالة الأولى, the three categories. الحالة الأولى وهي شر, وهي شرها أن تدخل عليهم. والثانية وهي دونها يدخل عليك. والثالثة هو الأسلم أن تعتزلهم فلا تراهم ولا يرونك. Imam Ghazali talking about the time of the dictators taking people's life, oppressing people. أما الحالة الأولى وهي الدخول عليهم وهو مذموم جدا في الشرع وفي تغليظات وتشديدات توارد بها الأخبار والآثار فنقلها لتعرف تذم الشرع له لمن يتعرض له ما يحرم منه ويباح منه وما يكره وما تقدير الفتوى بظهر العلم. Imam Ghazali is talking about a group of intellectuals, scholars, people, individuals who support injustice, advocate for injustice, promote injustice, and a person who doesn't do something wrong, they say, what? You are the greatest, there's nothing like you. It's okay, it's permissible for me to take people's life. Islam allow you to do that. Anyone who's opposition to you, peaceful protesters, just take their life. SubhanAllah, it's very timely. You heard about the fatwa recently of some people. He says, أما الأخبار فإنه لما وصف الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم والمرء الظلم قال فمن نابذهم ونجا ومن اعتزلهم سلم أو كاد أن يسلم ووقع معهم في دنياهم فهو منهم. He said, if a person were to hold them accountable, a person would be saved. Whoever stayed away from them, سلم أو كاد أن يسلم ومن وقع في دنياهم فهو منهم. Whoever wanted their dunya and sell his akhirah for few thousands of dirham or dinars or pounds or dollars, فهو منهم. Then he says, سيكون من بعد أمراء. After me will become أمراء. أمراء, that people in charge or that in power. يكذبون, they lie. ويظلمون, they commit injustice, oppress people. ومن صدقهم بكذبهم, whoever believe their lie. وأعانهم على ظلمهم, and help them to commit injustice. ليس مني ولست منه ولم يرد علي الحوض.
So does that mean these people, based on this hadith, they're not part of Muslim? They will not go.
He says, الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, I'm not putting in Islam or Adam. He said, سيكون من بعدي, will be after me, أمراء, people in charge. يكذبون, they lie. يظلمون, they commit injustice. فما صدقهم, whoever believed them in their lie. وأعانهم على ظلمهم, support them in their injustice. ليس مني, it's not part of me. ولست منهم, I'm not part of him. ولم يرد علي الحوض, will not drink from my hand. Okay. Therefore is very tough for what we hear. وأما الآثار فقال وقد قال حذيفة, حذيفة بن اليمان, إياكم ومواقف الفتن. He said, be careful of the place will be tested. قيل وما هي. He said, what are the place will be tested? قال أبواب الأمراء, the doors of أمراء. Those, الأمير is a person in charge. يدخل أحدكم على الأمير. Someone enter of a person of authority. فَيُصَدِّقُهُ بِالْكَذِبِ. The person is lying, the person is doing the wrong things, and he said, yeah, you're right. وَيَقُولُ مَا لَيْسَ فِيهِ. And the person praise him with something that doesn't have, it's not on him. وَقَالَ أَبُو ذَرِّ لِسَلَمَةَ يَا سَلَمَةَ لَا تَخْشَى أَبْوَابَ الصَّلَاتِينَ فَإِنَّكَ لَا تُصِيبُ مِنْ دُنْيَاهُمْ شَيْئًا إِلَّا أَصَابُوا مِنْ دِينَكَ أَفْضَلَ مِنْهُ. Abu Dharr had a position against establishment, you know, at his time. He said to Salama that if you are into that circles, they will take more of your deen than you take from their dunya. And therefore he mentioned many examples. But there's some people, they were very important in the Islamic history, that they have corrected what has gone wrong. Among them, Imam Bainam Al-Izz ibn Abd al-Salam. Al-Izz ibn Abd al-Salam, in his stand against injustice in Egypt, have changed the whole political situation. The ruler committing injustice, Al-Izz ibn Abd al-Salam, decided to leave Egypt. He said, I'm leaving. When he's leaving, people start living with him. They were leaving too. Then the Amir said, what do you want? He did non-violence protest. He said, what do you want? He said, I want you to change your course of action, your direction. And he said, we're going to change it, because we don't like you to leave. Al-Izz ibn Abd al-Salam, and therefore they accept and they stayed. He says Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it the condition for a person who visited the Sultan is to speak the truth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لُتُبَيِّنُنَّهُ لِلنَّاسِ وَلَا تَكْتُمُونَهُ. You speak the truth and don't conceal the truth. The other thing is that a person who will give an advice to the person in authority, he's reducing the impact of this person by giving them the right advice so they can change their action. Because some people say, you should not involve in politics. Some people say that. That's just wrong. Even people say voting is haram. Where people, you know, choosing someone running for office and reducing the harm might come from a particular person's policy is better than have a person might cause harm to the community or to society. Therefore, this is the philosophy behind that. قبل أبو بعيد الجراح رضي الله عنه. And he said, is it permissible for people to show respect and honor for a person in charge? Imam al-Ghazali says nothing wrong with that. As long as you're not helping the person to become unjust. You give the people what they deserve in terms of their title. A person does not commit injustice, a person in authority, your manager. He said, don't call me with my first name, call me Mr. You call them Mr. You see the officers, you call him officers. Judge, you call honorable, your honor. Nothing wrong with that at all. Because you're giving a person the title he deserves or being given to them. Our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he wrote letters to the kings of Abyssinia and the king of Egypt, what did he say? Oh dude, how are you, hi, guy? What did he say to them? To the great man of Egypt, to the king of Byzantia, Azim al-Rum, Azim al-Furs, give the people the title that they deserve.
But those were not Muslims.
Even they're not Muslims.
In Islamic society, when you start segregating based on titles, or that can create some artificial...
No. In relationship of work, relationship of authority, you give a person the authority they deserve. You're talking to an officer, police officers. You say officer. He's an officer. That's his title. That's his job. You are standing before a judge. So your honor, talking to the judge. Nothing wrong with that at all. Give people the title that society given them. The title in the eyes of Allah, that's another thing. But the title of dunya, you give them. Let me give you the general principles. I said that before, let me just go. Every time you see somebody, a popular, in a higher place, you have to deal with them in the following way. It's my advice. Number one, any title of dunya, a person given them, as long as the title is not the wrong title. He's not calling himself Pharaoh, calling himself the God. You know, like Pharaoh said, "An Rabbukum al-A'la." You call him Rabbukum al-A'la? No. As long as it does not contradict with the principles of Islam. Number two, they recognize a person's authority, as long as that person is not committing injustice, or wrong you, or wrong other, you recognize the person's authority. Always. Number three, that you don't make a person enlarge them in your head more than they should be. They're human beings, they go to sleep, they eat, they die, they relieve themselves, they go to the bathrooms. So it does not come to your head. Because Fir'aun, if people have thought that about Fir'aun, they would not have worshipped him at all. Huwa bashar. Even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about Isa alayhi salam, when people started worshipping Isa, what Allah said about Isa? What did he say about him? They used to eat food, which is a human thing. Why is this prophet eating food and walking and shopping like anyone else? Therefore, you cannot give people more than, and that's called idolizing people. Why people start worshipping people? Because they don't think about them at the time, they're a human being like them. You know? That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Mustafa sallallahu alaihi, the best human being walked on this earth, mashallah. What did he say to the man when he saw him and started shaking? Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has an awe, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Let me ask you this. You're walking on earth, and over suddenly you saw a moon, the real moon in front of you, the moon. The moon come from there. Yeah. You don't get shocked if you see the moon, the light of the moon. For the man saw Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he came to Medina thinking that he was going to sing up to say sometimes. You know, psychologically, emotionally, sometimes you are not prepared for something. Even when you eat food, you expect something sweet in its sour. Or sour is sweet. Didn't you? Something happened to you? You get shocked a little bit. This man entering in Medina heard about Rasulullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Rasulullah. Therefore, he thought, I was going to go to the city. I'm going to check in the hotel. There's no hotel at that time. I'm going to really refresh. Then I'm going to seek. I'm going to make an appointment. And then see Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Therefore, he prepared himself for emotional stages. But he got to Medina. And the first gathering of people that he asked them, he said, I want to see Muhammad, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Abu Bakr Siddiq radhiallahu anhu said, yeah, he is. He's Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The man looked at Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, started shaking from top to toe. He was not prepared. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, look at him, and he said, Hawwin alayk, come down. Imagine him smile because always he smiles. Come down. Wallahi ma ana illa min umra'atin kanat ta'kulu al-qadid. I'm nobody except a son of a woman couldn't afford fresh meat. She used to eat dry meat. By the way, I grew up eating dry meat too. You know, in the village, you eat fresh meat once a week. You don't slaughter all the time. Because only there was a butcher, one butcher place in the village. You don't slaughter every day. Then when you buy that, the fresh, what do you want to do? Eat the rest of the week? You eat dry meat? You cook dry meat. You mix it with vegetable and so forth. But it's a life free of anxiety. Seriously. In village, that's where I was live, there's no anxiety. There's no stress. It's stressing about what? It's very simple. You wake up in the morning, Fajr time. You go to the masjid, you pray Fajr. You drink your tea or eat your home donuts. You go to the farm, you work until 10 o'clock. You eat another meal. You work until Dhuhr time. You come pray Dhuhr. And then the whole village go to sleep. They can take a nap. Yeah, because it's called Qailula. Then you come to Asr time. You go back to the farm. You work until sunset. You come home. You pray Maghrib. You socialize until Isha time. You will visit one another, chat, and so forth. There's no electricity. There's no TV. There's no iPad. There's no iPod. Nothing. You do that, and then you go to sleep. And the next day, you start the same thing. It sounds very romantic. That was it. It was very simple. And people lived in at age of 96, 97, 85, 86. Ate organic food, drank from the Nile. Anyway, the man, for Rasulullah said, "Hawin alayk, ana ibn Umratin kana ta'kul al-qadid." It's dry meat. Subhanallah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Laysa bi malik, he's not a king. But he's better than any king walking this earth. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that's why sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sleeping on a rough mat. You know, mat made out of this palm tree's leaves. فَأَثَّرَ عَلَى جَنْدِهِ. He made a mark on his body. So he sat down. فَعُمَرَ ضَلَعُهُ saw the mark of the... And the Rasulullah sallam, قَالَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ, you sleep in this rough mat. And king of Persia and king of Byzantia, they sleep on silk, ينامون على الحرير. Your Rasulullah sleeping on the floor, on the mat. And those kings sleeping on the silk, the baji wal harir. فقال يا عمر, يا عمر, لا تريد أن تكون لهم الدنيا وتكون لنا الآخرة. Then he want them to, let them have the dunya, I want to have the akhirah. ما أنا, قال الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, ما أنا إلا كرجل استظل بذي ظل شجرة. I'm not no one except like a person who, a man who rested under the tree. ثم تركها. The dunya, like resting under a tree, a shade, a passing shade, temporary shade. It doesn't last. Therefore, this you remember about the person in power. The other things you remember about the people in power and somebody in authority, whomever you visit and you talk to, this advice, by the way, my father gave me. It helped me a lot because I do deal with people in authority and people in power. He said, you have to remember that person has to die one day. Every human being, they will die one day. That for sure. And they will be resurrected. And they will be barefoot and naked before Allah Almighty. No matter how much power they have in the dunya. With no help, with no cloud, with no people are surrounding them. They come in alone. And then he says, every time in a gathering, you're any gathering, gathering of the wealthiest, of the richest, of the famous, of anything, you have to look at it from the akhirah perspective to say, this regroup this area, this people. Imagine them, the same crowd in akhirah, where they will be. You're in big gathering, and people flashing all kind of clothing and so forth. Close your eyes, imagine, subhanAllah, it's akhirah time, I'm being resurrected, the people around me being resurrected, where we will be, all of us? Which place? Which among us will be under the shade of Allah in the Day of Judgment, under the throne? And who will not? God the flesh, that is really the person that you need to look at. If you talk about shiny things, because the manabir, they sit on it, the seats, min nur, made of light. Therefore, no one can miss it. يجلسون على منابر من نور. على منابر من نور. The seating is on light. The seat made of light. And how? من قدمه الله تقدم ومن أخره الله تأخر. Whoever Allah put him in the front will be in the front, and whoever Allah put him in the back will be in the back. Yeah. You know, one of the مشايخ in Sudan, well-known Sheikh, then Farah al-Taktub. He was invited. He was on a guest of honor to a gathering. He come to the gathering with the humble clothes. He went to see how much those people really liked him for who he is. He didn't dress his best. The doorman didn't allow him. He said, "I'm the man who's been honored tonight." He said, "You're lying. Get out of here. You don't look like it." Well, in simple clothes, casual, they call it, America, casual clothes. Well, he went and he wore something like this and wore the nice clothes and came back. And they said, "Oh, you look different. Now you can enter." The man entered. When they brought him the food, he did this to his sleeve. He took the sleeve and he put it in the dish. He said, "Eat," to the sleeve. They said, "Sheikh, you won't crazy, what's wrong?" Why? He said, "Because he was invited, I'm not." You get it?
Our food is, yes.
You invited the clothes. Allahu Akbar. But that's what he said. And by the way, in the issue of kissing the hand of a scholar, this is also an issue. People said, is it permissible to kiss the hand of a scholar or somebody that you respect, your fathers and so forth? Imam al-Ghazali said, قَبَّلَ أَبُو عُبَيْدَ الْجَرَّاحِ رَضَى اللَّهُ عَنْهُ يَدْ عَلِي كَرَّمَ اللَّهُ وَجْهَهُ. Abu Ubaidah ibn al-Jarrah, he kissed the hand of Imam Ali رَضَى اللَّهُ عَنْهُ كَرَّمَ اللَّهُ وَجْهَهُ. Therefore, it's permissible, he says. لَمَّا أَنْ لَقِيَهُ بِالشَّامِ. And no one said to him, "You should not have done that." Okay. And therefore he says, showing respect and so forth to people who's in honorable places is almost is a sunnah. It's okay to do that. As I said before, calling them by their title. Okay. But let me just say one thing. Abu Ubaidah ibn al-Jarrah. Imam Ali is not like an ordinary person. Just so they don't get anything mixed here. Although he is Amir al-Mu'mineen, but he's Al al-Bayt, he's among the Salihin, among people of Jannah. It's not the same. Imam Ali, radiallahu anhu, Abu Turab. هذا الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم. Ali رضي الله عنه was sitting, Hassan and Hussein was sitting, Fatima was sitting. He took his garment and he threw it at them. هذا قال هذا عترتي. This is my family. So he's a special man. So not Abu Ubaidah ibn al-Jarrah kissed his hand. Every Muslim should have kissed his hand and kissed his head also as well. Because it's Ali. I'm saying you should not just apply this for any person. he says, فأما السكوت فإنه سيرى في مجلس من الفرش الحرير وأن الفضة والحرير والمربوس عليهم وعلى غلمانهم وهو حرام. He said, if a person were to enter a gathering where he will not be able to say what he can, yani the point here, say if I go to a gathering and somebody says this gathering only be one way street, you will not be able to say anything. And you know what might be said is not acceptable. Then a person should not go to that gathering because he will not be able to say anything about it. Because silence is what?
Acceptance.
Acceptance and approval. If you'll be able to say something about it, then you go. Okay? I remember we were sitting in a dinner, and the sister, may Allah bless her soul, rahimahullah, passed away. One of the strongest devoted Muslims I have seen in America, rahimahullah. She walked to every table of us, and she said, I want you to tell the president this, this, and that, and that. If you don't tell him, the food you ate is not halal. It's not permissible for you to be silent. She walked to every table. And subhanAllah, every person heard her, said the same thing to the person in charge. Every person said the same thing. Because she said, I want you to say this. And everyone else repeated the same thing. And in 1 week, things have changed. 1 week. Allah rahimah Allah. She was sitting in a gathering where somebody in charge, an authority in America, who alluded to that the sister who was in Turkey some time ago, that she wore in hijab, she was kicked out of the parliament. She said, why are you not saying anything? She said to them, why are you not saying anything, guys, about this violation of human rights? The guy said, the sister should have known better. Why is she wearing hijab and going to the parliament? Oh, so she tell him apart. She said, what are you saying? Are you saying to me Rosa Parks should not have sat where she has sat in America? Are you racist? Are you sexist? The guy, he didn't expect that from a lady wearing hijab. Bam, bam on him, he said, I'm sorry, I didn't mean that. She said, no. I pay you tax, I pay you salary. You cannot say this unwise things. What happened to you? He started apologizing the rest of the meeting. So I'm sorry, I didn't mean that. She said, no, you can do that. Therefore, that he said, a person should not be silent. Right? فهو يدعو للظالم أو يثني عليه أو يصدقه فيما يقول من باطن بصريح فقوله بتحريك رأسي باستبشار وجهي. He said, but a person should not make a dua, supplication, to support injustice. He said, somebody commit injustice, say, Allahumma tawil umrahu. Why are you asking Allah to give him more life? Tawil al-umr. Oh Allah, give him more power. You know he's committing, he not doing the right thing. No.
How about
you giving me a lucky straight back? He said, Imam Ghazali said, that's all you should say. He said, you ask Allah to have him to do the right thing. Ask him Allah to guide him. You ask him Allah him to help him to do what is right. He said, okay. But you cannot ask a person, somebody doing the wrong thing, and you encourage him not to do the wrong thing? You shouldn't do that. What time, the Maghrib?
No.
Huh? Tayyib, subhanakallah, alhamdulillah, illa. Astaghfirullah, atubu alayhi.
Yeah.
Dua, again, it's more for them. For them, yeah. For them, is Imam Ghazali said, it's worse if you're supporting them publicly.
Subhanakallah, alhamdulillah, la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar.